Hi everyone! Today I'm showing you how to make a repeating pattern of a watercolor painting in GIMP. I painted this Easter egg pattern in last week's video and today I'm scanning it, editing the scan in GIMP, turning it into a repeating pattern also in GIMP and uploading it to my Redbubble shop. So let's start with the scanning. Watercolor paintings tend to buckle unless you use very thick paper or stretch the paper before painting. To make sure the painting is flat while scanning it, I put a pile of normal white copy paper on top of it inside the scanner and I sometimes also put a weight on top of the scanner, like a pile of books, to make sure the painting is pressed against the scanner. Otherwise, some parts might not scan sharp enough. Moving on to the computer, I make sure the scanner settings are correct. I want it to be a colored scan and the resolution at least 600 dpi, and I'm saving the image as a PNG file. My scanner is a combined scanner and printer. It's called Epson XP245 Wi-Fi printer scan and copy machine, which means you can use it wirelessly. I'll link it below if you're interested. I think I chose it because it was the cheapest one I could find at the time. The scan needs some tweaking and I'm doing that in GIMP, which is a free image editing software. If the image is a bit crooked, you can use the rulers as guides and straighten out the image with the rotate tool. The next thing I'll fix is adjusting the levels. I'm going to colors and levels and choosing the white eyedropper and clicking on the lightest part of the image and choosing the black eyedropper and clicking on the darkest part of the image. This works well if you have something white and something black in the image. I didn't have anything that dark in this painting. You can also just use the brightness contrast tool. Then I'm adjusting the sharpness by going to filters, enhance, sharpen. Looking at the preview image, I increased sharpness as much as possible without making the image look grainy. These are the basic things I usually do to edit the painting. With this one, I also tried if I could make the yellows a bit brighter with the hue saturation tool, but it didn't really work. So finally, I cropped the image with the rectangle select tool and going to image, crop to selection. And I exported the image as a PNG file. To turn this into a repeating pattern, I go to Layers, Transform, Offset, and click on the button that says Offset by X divided by 2, Y divided by 2, and click Offset. Now you can see the edges between the repeating images. We have to blend those in so that the pattern looks seamless. I'm using the clone tool and making the brush size bigger, and then choosing the area I want to clone by pressing down ctrl and clicking the part I want to copy. I'm also decreasing the opacity to make the blending smooth. And then I'm just painting over the harsh lines I want to blend out. I've made two similar videos before about making a repeating pattern in GIMP. This one differs from them in that the painting has a background, so you have to do the blending part. But other than that, it's the same process. When I think I'm done with the clone stamping, I'm gonna fill out the empty area in the middle. I open another copy of the edited painting and cut out two eggs with the free select tool. I copy them by pressing ctrl C and go back to the repeating unit and paste them with ctrl V. I'm also using the rotate tool to turn them in different positions so that they don't look too similar to the original X I copied. I also turn the X into new layers. I export the whole thing as a PNG to make sure the extra X are included in the image. But I also save the GIMP file so that if I want to tweak the positions of the two X later, I can do that since they're on different layers. I can upload this image straight to Redbubble because Redbubble allows you to tile the image, but I'll also show you how it looks tiled in GIMP. I'm going to Filters, Map, Tile, and increasing the width and height. And here's the tiled image. It's a seamlessly repeating pattern. But make sure you use the last exported PNG file for this so that those extra layers are also included. Moving on to Redbubble to upload this image for art prints and other merch. I'm going to add new work and I'm choosing the one repeating unit to upload to all products. You can edit the image and choose the way you want it to repeat. In this case, I'm choosing the regular grid for it to tile correctly. If you want to check out this or other paintings in my Redbubble shop, I'll leave a link below. Thank you so much for watching and I hope you found this useful. Subscribe for more art videos like this, I upload a new one every Friday. Bye!